or the war field to attract more people, to make it more effective so that we can actually understand the whole philosophy. So, as I was mentioning, Arjuna was in the middle of the battlefield, and he was asking Krishna that, Krishna, please take me to the middle of the battlefield so that I can see who are all there to fight against me. So that's when Arjuna is asking Krishna, Senayor Ubhyor Madhye Ritam Sthape Me Arjuna. Sthape Me Achyuta. Oh Achyuta, oh Krishna, please take me to the middle of the Sena, middle of the battlefield, so that I can take a darshan. I can see who are all there to, you know, have come to fight with me. Then when Arjuna see that all the his grandfathers, you know, his teachers, his gurus, his maternal uncles, his cousin brothers, everybody was there, and then Arjuna got bewildered, and then Arjuna was telling, like, you know, Drishbhimam Swajanam Krishnam Yuvitsam Samupasthitam, you know, by seeing Swajana. Because when Arjuna was actually, initially he was, quote, so much fired up to fight against this Kauravas, because Kauravas has done so much bad thing towards Pandavas. They were on exile, and then they were trying to poison Bhima, they tried to disrobe Draupadi. All these kind of bad things were done to Pandavas. So Arjuna was so much fired up, ready to fight against the Kauravas. So that's when Arjuna was saying, Lo, Dardrashtena Durbuddheya. The sons of Dhritarashtra, who are Durbuti. Durbuti means who are evil-minded. I wanted to fight with them. I wanted to see them. But when Arjuna came, and when Arjuna hit with the reality, was about to fight, and on the other side was Bhishma. Bhishma Drona Pramukthakya. The Bhishma was there, his loving grandfather, great-grandfather, and his loving guru, Drona. Everybody was there. Then Arjuna was completely bewildered. Arjuna was felt with the feeling. And then that Durbuddhe, the evil-minded people, immediately become Swajana. Right? Drishtu imam Swajanam Krishna. Oh Krishna, they are my Swajanas. They are my own people. How will I kill them? I cannot kill them. And then Arjuna is saying, like, Arjuna is giving five reasons not to fight in the first chapter. Five reasons. The first one is compassion. The second one is that, how will I enjoy, if I kill all of them, how will I enjoy this kingdom without my Swajana, without my grandfather? Because pretty much practically, it was Bhishma Dev who brought up all the five children, because their father was dead long before. Pandu was dead long before. So it was Bhishma Dev, who was great grandfather, who brought them up. So Arjuna was lamenting, how will I enjoy the kingdom without my grandfather? How will I enjoy the kingdom without my guru? How will I enjoy the kingdom without my other kingsmen? So Arjuna was thinking, okay, there's no way I can enjoy this kingdom without my family. So first is compassion. The second one is, there's no point in enjoyment in this without my family. And the third one is that I will incur sin if I kill my family. And the fourth one, it's destruction of family tradition. If all the great members of the family is gone, if all the elderly people in the family is gone, then the whole tradition and culture will be completely gone, decline. And then there will be unwanted progeny. And the fifth one is indecision. Arjuna didn't know finally what to do. Finally, Arjuna says, let them kill me at least. Sad way, I will not incur this sin. So there are five reasons Arjuna was telling not to fight the war. And we have to understand the fact that Arjuna was one of the greatest warrior in the Kurukshetra war. Only second to Bhishma Dev. Such a warrior, when he says that, okay, I cannot fight, let my enemy kill me, that will be good. So that kind of deep depression Arjuna was in, that kind of dilemma and bewilderment Arjuna was in. And at end, Arjuna loses his heart. So in the first chapter, Arjuna is just, it's called Arjuna Vishada Yoga. First is called, the first chapter is also called the observation of army. Sainya Nirikshan. The first chapter is also called Arjuna Vishada Yoga. So Acharya says that Arjuna showed the utmost compassion. Even though the Kauravas has done so much of bad things to the Pandavas, still Arjuna was showing that most compassion. So the Acharya says that Arjuna represents the true devotee. The true devotee in a bewildered condition, ready to accept the jnana. What jnana? The jnana of Gita, the knowledge of Gita, the nectar of Gita. So it was setting the scene for Arjuna to receive, and Arjuna is the appropriate candidate to receive the knowledge from Krishna. So in Krishna, in chapter 2, which is the overview of Bhagavad Gita, chapter 2 is called the overview of Bhagavad Gita. In chapter 2, Krishna started speaking. When Krishna see that Arjuna is actually on a dilemma, on a confusion, Krishna starts speaking that kutastva kashmalamitam vishame samupastitam. Oh Arjuna, how come you are in such a bad situation? From where this impurities has come to you? So Krishna is actually giving a pep talk. Krishna is actually slightly chastising Arjuna, asking from where these impurities have come to you? You are a great warrior. You should not be speaking like this. Klaibhyam masmagam apartha. Klaibhyam means, how can you become important? You are talking as if you are unimportant. So, this is not good. Right? So then, it is said that, then immediately Krishna was giving the examples of, you know, giving the philosophy of soul. Krishna is saying like, you know, Arjuna, you don't have to lament. You are completely unbecoming of a warrior. You are a warrior and you should not be lamenting. Why? By killing your kinsmen, or by killing the enemy, you are not killing their soul. You are just killing their body. So Krishna, in the second chapter, the first quarter of the second chapter, Krishna is actually talking about the soul. Krishna is saying like, you know, okay, you don't have to lament. Right? All these different wonderful shlokas, Dehino Asmin Yata Dehe Kaumaram Yavanam Jara, and then Antavanta Ime Deha Nitya Shokta Sharirina, right? Najayade Mriyadeva Kadajit Nayam Bhutva Bhavita Vanabhuya Ajo Nityam Shashvatam Shashvatoyam Na Hanyade Hanyamane Sharire. You cannot actually kill the soul. You can only kill the body. So why are you lamenting? So throughout the Bhagavad Gita, in the second chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, initially, Krishna, what we are seeing is that Krishna is slowly bringing Arjuna in a calm position, bringing him down, in the sense like, you know, to calm down, don't worry. Throughout the first half of the second chapter, Krishna is saying, Naptum shochitum arhasi, nanu shochitum arhasi, naivam shochitum arhasi. What does that mean? Do not lament. So you can see that, in what mood Arjuna is. Arjuna is completely depressed. Arjuna is completely bewildered. And here, Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, his topmost friend of Arjuna. See how, can you see how much fortunate Arjuna is? If we are in a such a bewildered situation, what is the chance that we will be getting a best friend to console us? Like Arjuna. Arjuna got the best friend, and that too the Supreme Personality of Godhead to console. So first thing Krishna said that, okay, don't worry. Do not lament. Everything will be alright. Right? Why? Because you are not killing the soul. The soul still goes on. Na hanyade hanyamane sharire. You are only killing the sharira. The soul is going on. Right? It goes on and on. Right? So then, Krishna is just telling that, ashyocha nanva shochastvam. Do not lament. So Srila Rupa Goswami is actually, the Sandarbhas, it's saying that Krishna starts with telling that ashyochan. Shocha means lamentation. Ashyocha means do not lament. And Krishna is ending with the shloka saying, what was the last shloka? Mashuchaha sarvadharman parityagya mamekam sharanam raja aham tvam sarva papebhyo mokshayishyami mashuchaha. Shucha and shocha are same. Right? So, shocha means lament. Ashochyan, and he is ending with shocha. So, starting and ending with the same message. What is the message? Do not lament. So, the whole Bhagavad Gita's message is to say, it is to make Arjuna free from lamentation. Right? The whole Bhagavad Gita is speaking by Krishna to Arjuna to free him from lamentation. So, what happens is that Krishna offers encouragement throughout the Bhagavad Gita. Through encouragement to Arjuna. And in between, Krishna is providing enlightenment. So, what's happening? Throughout the Bhagavad Gita, from the beginning to end, Krishna is providing encouragement to Arjuna. And in between, Krishna is giving enlightenment. So, this thing, this two has to go together. What are the two things? Encouragement and enlightenment. So what happens is that encouragement without enlightenment. What happens if there is encouragement? So for example, if one person is on a problem. So if the friend is coming and he simply gives on encouragement without enlightenment. Enlightenment what? Give the proper understanding of the situation. Give the solution for the situation. So if he only give the encouragement, then what happens that it is not substantial. It's just an encouragement. It's just not substantial. But then what happens if there is enlightenment without encouragement? If it is enlightenment without encouragement, then there is no confidence. Right? So this has to go together. Like the encouragement and enlightenment. So Krishna, in the second chapter, is actually giving Arjuna that enlightenment and encouragement. Right? So that's when Krishna is actually slowly and slowly bringing Arjuna to in a position wherein Arjuna is set, his mind is set, so that he can receive the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. Because Arjuna is not ready. When a person is completely bewildered, if for example, if he is his mind is completely depressed, he will be completely shut down from all the advices, or shut down from all the, enlightenments. So what Krishna did that, okay, you calm down, don't worry, we can see what we can do. So then Arjuna has been brought down to that level so that he is ready to receive the knowledge. So that is on the second chapter. And the second chapter, Krishna is actually then speak about the different philosophy after, you know,